Hey, what's going on, guys? Louis Reverend Flame here, back bringing you another episode of Hogwarts Legacy. Actually, I think I'll put my webcam right over here. There we go. Alright, so if I remember correctly, let's have a look at this. Why don't we go and do, I'm also going to there. Oh, and before I forget, guys. I am now decked out in the Dark Arts. Alright, guys. Let's go have some fun dueling.
over there. Leviosa.
Can I help you?
Sebastian told me to see you about a club.
If Sebastian vouches for you, that's all I need to know. I coordinate duels for crossed ones. A dueling club of sorts. It's invitation only, so you must have really impressed Sebastian.
I seem to have a knack for dueling.
Then you've come to the right place.
How does cross ones work exactly?
You show up, I match you with other duelists, and whoever is still standing in the end wins. It's our way of determining the school's greatest duelist once and for all. And to liven things up, the winner is awarded a prize. Interested?
Of course. Dueling's an entertaining pastime.
I agree. Besides, in Crosswands, you could duel with a partner if you like. Your first time I'll pair you with Sebastian. Next time, you'll need to bring a partner along, or duel alone. So, care to step into the ring?
Get me in the ring.
Spectacular! Let the fireworks begin!
We'll make you regret signing up.
Sebastian wasn't wrong about you. There's strong competition ahead, but keep this up, and you could be the next school champion.
Brilliant. Count me in.
I shall. Now, it takes time to organize these duels, but check with me later. I may have something lined up for you. Again, congratulations on your first Crossed Ones victory. Well fought. Hope to see you back here again.
Alright, guys. So, now let's head over to Charms. And have our first Charms class. Lesson.
Some of us don't necessarily want him to get back to the lesson.
All right, guys, here we are.
Here, behind you, there is an open seat here.
Thank you.
Hello, I am Nettie. So you are the new student. Have you met Professor Ronan yet?
Shall we begin? Welcome to year 5 of Charms. Now, this will be a crucial year in your education on the art of charm work, but I am confident that we will take hold with a passion and rigor requisite of such a challenge. Right? Now, everyone, please open your textbooks to page 517. But before we begin, Can anyone here tell me the difference between the incantations of the color change and growth charms? Anyone? Anyone? Hmm? I am afraid it is too late to study now. Hmm. My, the summer months must have really taken a toll on you all. By the looks of it, you all spent your holidays practicing Obliviate on one another. Do you even remember how to perform a basic summoning charm? Well, it seems that we are in dire need of review. Everyone get into pairs and take positions on opposite sides of the classroom. Now let's put those textbooks to use as the blunt objects you so believe they are, and take turns summoning them out of one another's hands. Only one book will be needed per partnership, Miss Dale. Thank you. Get into place now. A lot of potential, but remember, potential is nothing without practice. Keep at it. You might just rival Miss Onai here. Very good, everyone. That's enough of that. Well, as you all seem to have the basics down, and it is an exceptionally lovely day, I was thinking that we might have ourselves a little excursion outside for a spot of fresh air. After me. I've always found that fun goes hand in hand with mastery, as I'm sure the Quidditch players amongst us would agree, So, what better than a bit of sport to put our prowess with the summoning charm to the test, right? So why don't we have our newest student start us off,
Oh, this is gonna be fun.
Very simply, cast Accio on one of the spheres and relinquish your charm at the last possible moment. Accio, think of this like splendid! Excellent control there. Stay focused. Very good. Points to Gryffindor. But there's certainly no sport in playing without some friendly competition. Miss Onai, would you care to give our new student a bit of a challenge? Come on up.
A challenge? Yes. Let's go. Let's have a challenge.
Just as before, and Miss Onai, you are playing red. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Let us begin. There we go.
Yes!
Now that is how you do things.
Let us make this a bit more interesting, shall we?
I think we are well past interesting at this point.
I'll say.
Enough chatter. Focus now. You will need it. This round settles it all.
Here we go! There we go.
Happens to the best of us. Very good, both of you. Well done.
Well, you can't win all of them.
Class is dismissed. Gather your things on the way out.
Well done back there. You took the loss in stride. Didn't want to go too easy on you. Took me weeks to become proficient with Akio. Took weeks for me to get anything right when I transferred here. It gets easier, I promise.
That's good to hear. It's a lot to take in all at once.
To put it lightly, I remember how I felt when I first arrived. I transferred here from Ouagadou just before my fourth year. My mother received an offer to teach divination here. Before I knew it, we had left Uganda and were halfway around the world at a new school in a new country.
Well, it's been nice talking and competing with you.
And with you. Ah, I think Professor Ronan wants to talk to you. Better not keep him waiting. Until next time.
Of course, you can use Akio.
A word, if you would.
You wanted to speak with me, Professor?
I did. I trust your first charms lesson lived up to expectation?
Well, an outdoor competition wasn't exactly the lesson I was expecting, sir.
What charm is there in the expected? Miss Onai is a talented witch. Take it in stride. One often gains the most from the battles one has lost. Of course,
that is
Professor,
very true.
It was a challenging match.
Miss Onai is always a fierce competitor, though I sense that she is a bit distracted of late. Now, Professor Weasley has asked that your professors give you instruction outside of the ordinary curriculum. Expect to hear from me soon regarding a special assignment that I am preparing for you.
I leveled up.
Thank you.
student, aren't you? Ugh.
Let's see. All right, let's go see Professor Weasley, and then get started with the real fun. Here we are.
What about the room, Professor?
I was thinking the same thing, Deke. Perhaps you could help.
Oh, excuse, Deke.
Ah, there you are. I trust your first classes went well?
They did, Professor.
I heard as much from Professors Hecate and Ronan. Seems Professor Fig taught you quite a bit during your brief detour near... What was it you said? Some ruins? I'd wager there's a good deal more to your travels here than what you've told me. Isn't there?
Have you and Professor Fig not discussed my training?
He continues to be reticent about the details, mentioning only a few spells. Revelio, was it? And Lumos?
That's correct, Professor.
I see. Like trying to get a sonnet from a Strela. Regardless, you must continue to build upon what you've learned. In that regard, I've asked your professors to help hasten your progress with some extra assignments.
Professor Ronan did mention something about that.
In fact, Professor Ronan will meet you outside momentarily to assign your first one. Now, regarding the trip to Hogsmeade I mentioned earlier, we've arranged to replace the supplies lost on your way here, including seeds, potion recipes, and spellcrafts.
Thank you, Professor.
And Mr. Ollivander will connect you with the perfect wand. You've managed your classes well with a borrowed wand, but you'll find the magic you cast with your own wand to be far superior.
Let's go.
I need to get to Hogsmeade.
Very well. I'd like you to make your first visit to the village with a classmate. Help you get your bearings. Perhaps Sebastian Sallow or Natsai Oni. I've noticed you spending time with them.
I'd like to go with Sebastian.
Glad to hear it. Mr. Sallow is a capable young wizard, and he knows the area. He'll keep you well clear of any of Victor Rookwood's undesirables en route.
Rookwood?
A rather unsavory local. Best to avoid him and his associates, including his right hand of sorts, Theophilus Harlow, if you can. Once you've finished Professor Ronan's assignment, your friend will meet you at the castle doors. No time to waste. The sooner you complete your work, the sooner you can enjoy a butterbeer at the Three Broomsticks.
Let's go! Ha ha ha!
Ah, there you are!
You have a new spell to teach me, Professor.
Indeed I do, and an exceedingly useful one at that, the mending charm, Reparo. Fixes things right up, makes a broken object good as new in the blink of an eye.
It seems as if that might come in handy.
More frequently than one would imagine. As Professor Weasley mentioned, I am not the only one who will be teaching you spells outside of class in an effort to catch you up with your peers. A number of your professors have agreed to do so as well. But first, Each shall ask that you complete a few preliminary tasks to hone your magic. I have arranged some for today. See them through and then report back to me. We will have you casting Reparo in no time.
Let's go.
I'll start on the task right away, Professor. This is the right area. I wonder where the flying paint is.
Revelio. Revelio.
Flying page must be around here somewhere.
If only a new student would help me with my sad predicament.
Revelio.
Trust the preliminary tasks.
I completed the assignments, Professor.
Marvelous. You clearly know your way around basic charms. Let us give the old mending charm a try then, shall we? Remember to be deliberate in your enunciation and movements. I want to see some vigor. Now, wand at the ready.
Yes, sir.
Remember, your wand is a conduit of your magic.
Reparo.
That's it. Very good. If you would like to practice mending something, have a go with that broken statue in the alcove by the water. It allegedly Reparo. Symbolized heartbreak. Perhaps a jilted lover would be too accurate and lashed out.
I do believe it is now time to head to Hogsmeade.
Well, fancy meeting you here.
Hello, Sebastian.
Ah, my new charge.
I'm told you're in dire need of supplies, and I'm to accompany you into Hogsmeade for them. Is this your first foray into the village?
It is. I haven't left the castle since I arrived.
Well, I shall endeavor to be the very best of guides, then. Hogsmeade's a charming little place. Self-contained, too. We should be able to find you everything that you need. Shall we?
Let's go.
I was glad Professor Weasley asked me to join you today.
As am I. Thank you, by the way.
Of course. You're the only one who's ever bested me in a duel. The way I see it, I'd be wise to keep an eye on you. Speaking of Weasley, she seems to have taken quite a shine to you.
Has she? That's nice to hear.
I'm still surprised that a professor would entrust me with anything, given my detention record.
Spend a lot of time in detention, do you?
Just enough to keep me well-rounded. Speaking of detention, this trip to Hogsmeade might have saved me from one.
Glad I could be of service.
Madam Scribner, the librarian, was on the hunt for me, as is often the case. Professor Weasley came to retrieve me, and I was able to convince old Scribner that I had somewhere to be.
So how did you manage to get on the librarian's bad side?
Well, I suspect it's a matter of differing opinions. She thinks I shouldn't be allowed in the restricted section, and I, on the other hand, am inclined to disagree. Oh. Just one moment. This is an excellent spot to gather lacewing flies. They're pretty to look at. If you stew them long enough, they make a powerful potion ingredient.
I'll just collect those and we'll be on our way. This is going to be some fun.
What's going on?
See for yourself. Quite a sight, isn't it? You certainly don't see that every day.
Hippogriffs!
Do you think Poppy's already seen the hippogriffs?
Absolutely.
Likely already made.
To the left is the Forbidden Forest. Out of bounds to all students.
Oh, hence the name.
Precisely. They think it's too dangerous. I think they need to have more confidence in our defensive abilities. Ah! You can see Hogsmeade just past those ruins up ahead. Have you had much of a chance to explore the castle?
A little. It's positively enormous.
It is that. I've been there 5 years and barely scratched the surface. Loads to see, places to discover.
Oh? Any you'd like to share with the class?
Perhaps one day. I can't go around telling you all my secrets now, can I? You still haven't told me how you became so good at dueling.
I'm a natural, that's how.
I've always thought Thestral's pulling a carriage a bit grim. Though I suppose most people don't actually see them at all.
But you can see them.
Unfortunately. But you've seen quite a bit yourself firsthand too. Most notably that dragon attack. Hopefully the rest of your year isn't as eventful.
Oh, it probably will be. More eventful than that.
Mr. Moon! He's the Hogwarts caretaker. Looks a bit worse for wear. Hello, Mr. Moon. Have you met our new fifth year?
Pleasure! You might want to turn back, Mr. Sallow. Turn and run.
Is everything all right, sir?
Oh, look right at me! Eyes big as saucers!
What did, Mr. Moon?
Demi guys! Ugly and airy and terrifying. I shall be at the castle where it's safe. Good luck to both of you!
A Demi guys? I don't know what he's putting in his pumpkin juice, but he's obviously had too much of it. I've never seen Mr. Moon in such a state.
Mr. Moon is quite the character. My sister Anne thinks he's lovely, but I'd say he could improve a bit as a caretaker.
Oh, is your sister in Slytherin too?
She is, or rather, she was. She's not well at the moment, but she'll be better soon and back at Hogwarts. Honestly, if one could bottle the magic of this place, I don't know if it's the shops or the people, but there's just something about Hogsmeade. We all flock to it like moths to a flame. So how would you like to do this? Weasley told me you had a list of things to get, a wand and some other bits.
Yes, Dittany seeds, some spellcrafts, and some potion recipes.
Perfect. Can't wait to see what you do with the new wand. And a short list gives you plenty of time to poke around the village. I just have to pop into a shop to find something for my sister. Let's meet up in the town circle when you're finished. Remember, have fun. It's Hogsmeade.
Let's see. Gotta go here. Gotta go here. I also need to go Why don't we start by going to this shop here? There it is.
Oh.
An inquiring mind.
Pardon me, sir. I'm here for the spellcrafts Professor Weasley ordered.
Matilda, student. I thought I might be seeing you soon. I am the proprietor here, Thomas Brown. I take it you've had a conjuring lesson then?
I'm afraid I haven't yet, sir.
Ah, but you will soon enough. It is magic at its purest, creating something out of nothing. Of course, it is not without complexity, but that is where my spellcrafts come in. Stay the course. And you could soon impress even Professor Weasley.
That's certainly something to aspire to, Mr. Brown. I look forward to that day.
And I, too, see in it. Spellcrafts are incredibly useful for conjuring unique items like custom pieces of furniture or decoration. But I shall let Professor Weasley do the teaching. For now, let's get the spellcrafts you need. A potting table and a potion station, yes?
I believe so, sir.
Good. Nothing like being able to grow your own ingredients and brew what you want, when you want. Let's have a look. Let's look at what we have, shall we? If you're interested, feel free to take a look around at the rest of my inventory.
All right, now that we've knocked that out of the way, let's go and look at what ones I have left. If memory serves me correctly, I now need to go to potions and then the magic leap. And then I'll finish off with Ollivander. So, let's go.
Welcome to J. Pippin's Potions.
Pardon me, sir.
Oh, thank goodness. When I heard the bell, I thought you were Miss Lawang. Not that she deigns to come here. Though, I don't believe I've seen your face here before, either.
It's my first time in Hogsmeade, actually.
Is it really? Well, Parry Pippin at your service. And this is J. Pippin's Potions. Potions for all ailments. You'll have read it on the sign, of course, but Grandfather always made me say it in full. How may I help you today?
Professor Weasley sent me to collect some recipes. I'm new at Hogwarts.
You're the student she sent the owl about. I set your things aside immediately. I suspected if you're anything like I was at your age, you'd want your potion supplies. Is it not the most fascinating art, potion making? Rivals anything you can do with a wand, I've always said.
Are potions really that versatile?
They may not be as showy as spellwork, but make no mistake, they are just as powerful. They can heal, destroy, protect. You'll discover all of this soon enough. As it's your first time in, I should mention that it's not just potion recipes I sell. I also offer ready-made drafts for all manner of uses, and I unveil new ones from time to time. Pop in when you can so you don't miss out on anything. But for now, let's get you those recipes, shall we?
Let's go. I'll take this and this and...
Feel free to take a look at the rest of my inventory.
Nope, I don't have enough.
Come back another time if you're in a rush today.
See ya. I'm in a rush. Bye. Now, I need to go over to the magic items shop. I believe... No... Oh. If I remember correctly, it is this one.
Well, hello there!
Pardon me, sir. I'm here for the seeds Professor Weasley arranged for me to collect.
Here we are.
Antigone for the new fifth year. I take it that's you, then. Merlin's beard. Starting Hogwarts is a fifth year. You must be positively reeling from it all.
Not at all. I'm choosing to see it all as one big adventure.
Well, bravo. Not everyone has the temperament to take things as they come. Name's Timothy Teasdale, by the way. And this is my shop, the Magic Neep. I keep the cart out here because I like a good chat. Can't very well be in the thick of things if I'm hidden away inside now, can I?
I suppose not.
In addition to seeds, I have plenty of plants. Grow everything myself. My speciality is potion ingredients. Even Pippin purchases from me. But what say we get you a packet of Dittany seeds? Let me guess. You're after something fresh. Do have a look around. Plenty of ingredients to pique your interest, I'd wager.
Unfortunately, at this time, no. I am off to see the Wandmaker. I said the Wandmaker.
I'll be right with... Ah, it's you. Just a moment, please.
Hello, sir. I'm looking for...
For a new wand, yes. It's about time.
Yes, about time.
Well, you're our new fifth-year student, are you not? Oh, what am I saying? Of course you are. Gerbold Ollivander's the name. But of course, you'll have heard of the Ollivanders, I'm sure. Finest wand makers in the world. It's a
and also the wisest.
To meet you, truly. Now, come with me. Let's find you the perfect one, shall we? No, not you.
I am going to enjoy this.
Yes. Powerful core. 10.5 inches. You might do.
You might do.
Yeah. Give this one a try. wish it. Oh dear.
Well,
this isn't a good match at all, is it? We'll find you something, not to worry. No, not you. Perhaps. Yes. A rare wood, 13¾ inches, dragon heart string. Let's give this one a try. Looks like it's back to the shelf for you. This is proving to be trickier than I had anticipated. How perplexing. Where are you? Perhaps you? There you are. Yes. I think you might be the one. Here, take it.
Here we go.
Curious indeed.
I think I'll roll with this one at
curious indeed.
That color. I am going to go with
how intriguing.
No, I won't.
Curious indeed.
There it is.
How intriguing. Curious indeed. Intriguing.
A dragon heartstring wand is most powerful and learns what do you think?
Elder Wood, dragon heartstring core, 12½ inches.
Another wand, another beginning of a bright and magical future. Now, how did that feel?
Good. Different. I sensed a sort of surge of some kind.
A match. Your connection seemed particularly powerful. The right wand will learn from you just as you learn from it.
I'm eager to try it out.
I would imagine so. A wand with a dragon heartstring core is capable of dazzling magic. And the bond between you and your wand should only grow stronger. Do not be surprised at your new wand's ability to perceive your intentions, particularly in a moment of need.
That sounds wonderful, Mr. Ollivander.
I'll let you get to it. Do come and see me again if ever I can be of further assistance.
Well, that's everything. Better go and find Sebastian.
Alrighty, guys. Let's see here. Alrighty, guys. So, I do believe that that's going to wrap today's episode up. If you guys haven't already, please hit that subscribe button and notification bell to get notified on when I put out content. And if you guys are enjoying this series, please leave a like down below. And if you guys are looking forward to my later live stream, which I'll be doing later today, then I believe it'll be going on at about 1 o'clock for 3 to 5 hours, give or take. But I will say this much, guys. I am looking forward to completing this series. There's a lot to do, and I am running this series all the way up until I have 100% completed all challenges. Anyways, guys, until next time, stay strong, Knights of Flame.